I'd already begin done a warm summer night. Nothing could disturb him, nothing is in sight. Yet he hears something outside, a rattle perhaps, something that could be disturbing him from his deep recesses of his nap. His eye quivered and opened with sight, and he transitioned from an Indian accent to a Scottish in the middle of the night. He grabbed his head and went to the door. Surely what could be there was there no more. Steam and sweat poured down his brow. Stress was coming from every crevice, yet he wasn't even the slightest bit nervous. He laid back down in his bed, only to have a scratch awaken him again, and a rattle. Yet he needed something to use, so he opened up his cabinet and grabbed his torchlight. Surely the illumination would ease the poor bloke's suffering and consternation. He scanned the wall looking for something, whether it be small or tall. And then, there it is. The legendary, no legendary. The cat with the eye, Harry. That eye, I know that eye. It's BurFort. And then gone in a flash. Slam, I close my door.
Wipe that smirk off your face. You still got a problem? Aye, just the thing. The old trusty and faithful. A trusty sidekick, aye. Indeed, I'm grateful. My foe is so nefarious and cunning. His bowed move was quite stunning. BurFort executed his special move. The impudent paw slide of doom. His paw reached under the door. He had no designs to leave me alone anymore. I wasn't gonna take it lying down. My face had a smirk like Joker the evil clown. His paw was wretched and carving away. So I dropped to the floor like a sack of potatoes. I looked at him square in the eye. I could see his very worry. The stream let loose. The water hit his eye with a thunderous sploosh. No way he could have enjoyed it. Silence, BurFort, you blasphemous cat. Go away and take your own nap. But nay, he wouldn't let it slip away. He was getting ready to come back and make me pay. He used his little brain, seeing an object of mine to inflict. Double the emotional pain. BurFort put my shoe on his head. He was determined to not let me rest in my own damn bed. Shrouded behind a curtain, he most definitely certain, unveiled for all of us to see, he knew exactly what his target would be. He picked up the pace, with the tongue all over his face. It was a one-cat race. His head and my soul became one. He launched towards the door and BAM! I couldn't take it anymore. The damn fool knocked himself silly, obviously quite little dizzy. I stood at the door with a beam of light. He pretended he wasn't even in a fight. I wound up tight for the kick of my life. His eyes cast worry of physical strife. But like Bruce Lee or even Neo, he leapt before I could strike with my damn heel. Scampered and off he went into the basement for his beastly descent. He settled on his hiding place, so dark you couldn't see his cunning little face. Flailing towards my back, I turned and faced my foe. Time slowed down and seemed ever so slow. With precision and haste, I swung towards his miserable little face. Launching my attack, my broom knocked him with a crackling thwack. He was a flyer, all right. A flyer into my dryer. His head buried in the laundry stack. I celebrated my victory and get some sleep at last. But I know someday, damn old BurFort will come right back.